everybody. Here we are, all ready to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. Before we go down to Pine Ridge, I'd like to remind all you late vacationists and travelers not to forget a package of Horlicks on your trips. For 50 years now, travelers all over the world, from the North to the South Pole, have relied on this nourishing, sustaining malted milk. They find it a marvelous aid in case of travel sickness. Appetizing, easy to digest, Horlicks is often the one thing that delicate digestions can handle. That's why many folks who do a lot of flying rely implicitly on Horlicks. It's so nourishing and sustaining, such a well-balanced food, that it really takes the place of heavy meals. Being quick to digest, it doesn't cause distress as heavy meals so often do. And in addition, Horlicks is easy to prepare anywhere at any time. Just mix thoroughly with water, and it's ready to drink. So by all means, slip a package of Horlicks in your grip before you start. It will be a constant comfort on your trip. You can get Horlicks, you know, at any drugstore in both natural and chocolate flavors. And now let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. As a result of Lum's renewed popularity over rescuing Abner from his supposed kidnappers, the stockholders of the Great Western Sterling Silver Company have elevated Lum again to the office of president and general manager of the company. As you'll remember, Lum originally held the office after Squire Skimp had fleeced the citizens of Pine Ridge of all the money possible by the sale of stock in the mine. When Squire left for parts unknown, Lum assumed all the remaining stock and also the responsibilities of the company. As we look in on our old friends today, we find Lum down at Dick Huddleston's store, very much impressed with his regained importance. Listen.
So they come over and just insisted and begged and pleaded with me to take the office back, so finally I decided to do it.
Yeah, I heard they let you have the office back, Lum.
Yeah, it's a big responsible, all right, being president and general manager of a big silver mine like that, but whilst I don't like to cast no compliments right in my own face, I believe they used uncommonly good judgment in who they picked out.
Well, what are you going to do now that you've got the office?
Oh, I aim to go right on ahead, speaking to everybody just the same as usual, just like I ain't no better than air.
I mean, about the mine, Lum. What are you planning to do about it?
Oh, what I aim to do about it?
Yes, you ought to be figuring out some way to get some money out of it, pay off these stockholders.
Well, sir, you're just taking the words right out of my mouth, then. That's just exactly what I had in mind to do. And, Granny, you wouldn't make a bad president, you know what, Dave? Or vice president. You've got ideas. I can see that.
Well, I don't know about that, Lum, but I do know that these people here in town have invested ever since they could get in that stock ought to get their money back if there's any possible way to do it.
Why, sure. That's what I say. They use good judgment in putting a man like me in there to handle it for them. Somebody that can take right a hope and do things.
Yeah, you started telling me a minute ago what you plan to do.
Oh, well, to tell you the truth, Dick, I've got so many things in mind to do, I don't know which one to do first, hardly. What would you do if they'd give you the job of president and firm?
Well, of course, I'm not a stockholder in the company, and it's none of my business, Lum, but if I had charge of it, the first thing I'd do would be to try to sell it.
Just what I thought you'd say, for I aim to do the same thing myself. Who would you sell it to?
Why, anybody'd buy it.
There you are. Granny's me and you agrees on everything. Anybody'll buy it. I said the same thing to myself this morning. You don't happen to know anybody that's looking for a good silver mine, second-handed one, 14-carat sterling, do you?
No, I don't know of anybody offhand, Lum, but if it's any account at all, why, you ought to find somebody that'll buy it.
Well, now, right there's where I'm stumped. I've got everything all figured out but that. Who'll buy it?
Well, you've just got to get out and find somebody. Somebody that's in the mining business.
Well, I thought about that, but the trouble is, if they're already in the mining business, they wouldn't need no mine. They more than likely already have one.
Well, yes, but if there's any silver in that mine, why, you wouldn't have any trouble disposing of to some of those big operators out there.
Well, there's silver in it, all right. Didn't you see that big chunk of solid sterling silver that Squire Skim brought back from out there?
Yes, I saw it, but I still don't know where he got it.
Why, he dug it right out of our mine, dug it out himself.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Yeah, he admitted to it himself.
Of course, he might have gotten it out of some other mine.
Well, undoubtedly he knows which mine's ours. He wouldn't likely make a mistake and get out in the wrong mine.
No, if you've got silver and paying quantities out there, Lum, why, some of those big companies might be interested in operating a mine on a royalty basis.
Yeah, on what kind of a base was that?
A royalty basis. where they pay you so much royalty and all the silver they take from the mine. That'd be just as good as selling it.
It would, huh?
Why, sure. That's the way why you'd be operating on their captain.
Sure. Well, I believe you're on the right track there now, Dig. What did you call that word again, what you said they'd give us for the mine?
Royalty.
Yeah, that's the word, royalty. Hi, Grannies, it's a deal. I'm a good mind to do that.
Of course, those big companies would want to make some geological tests before they put any money in.
Why, sure. Make what kind of test was them, Dick?
A geological test. Make an analysis of the quality of the ore and find out how big the vein is.
Yeah, I had in mind to do the same thing myself, I think.
What's that, Lum?
Nothing. I was just studying some stuff over in my head here. Yes, sir, I believe that was a good idea I had on this royalty-based business. Good minds to let them have it.
Well, the thing for you to do, then, is to get in touch with some of those big mining companies and see if they're interested.
And the trouble is, I don't know the name of no other silver mine except this one of ours. Wouldn't do no good to write myself a letter. I'm a good mind to put an advertisement in.
Wait a minute, I believe it. Yeah, there's your rolling grocery store pulling up out there in front, Lum.
Yeah, all through making a round, I reckon. Granny, it'd take them long enough today, I'll say that. Abner and Grandpap have to sit and gossip at every house they stop at.
Yeah, I believe they enjoy that work.
They oughtn't to stop it right there in front of your store here, Dick. Ain't no way to do it.
Oh, well, that's all right. They're all through for the day anyway, just so they don't block the road out there.
No, I see. They just let Abner and Grandpap out. Cedric must be driving it on over to put it up.
Well, come in, fellas. Come in.
Yeah, how was business today?
Just on this holiday, Lum. We're out of so much stuff, missing lots of sales on account of it, too.
Well, you oughtn't to let the stock run down that way.
Well, you're the buyer. I've told you time and again what I always needin'.
Yeah, I'll call up the wholesale house quick as I get time. Been so busy on this silver mining business, ain't had time to breathe, hardly.
Is that the drinking water tray sitting there on the counter, Richard?
Yeah. Help yourself, Grandpa. Well, I'm going to have to go up here and sort the mail, fellas, and sawmill hands will be in here directly.
Yeah, go right ahead, Dick. Don't let us bother you. Just loafing. Well, Abner, I've figured out a way for us to make some money out of our silver mine.
Well, good.
I knowed if I kept turning it over and over in my head this way, I'd get an idea. I'm going to call a meeting of the stockholders for tonight and explain it all to them.
Did you hear that, Grandpap? Lum sat here and studied up an idea how he's going to make us all rich out of the silver mine.
Good for you, Lum. Good for you. What you got in mind to do?
Why, I'm going to get in touch with some of these other big mining companies, and instead of selling our mine to them, I'm going to make them give us a big royalty base for it.
Make them give us a what?
Royalty base. Of course, they got to make some geography tests to see how big their veins are first.
Well, I can't tell nothing from such talk as that, Lum.
Come over that again, Lum.
Well, the whole thing, boiled down, is that they've got to make analyses of the qualities of the ores and stuff like that before they let us operate on their capital.
Huh?
And if they silver there in paying qualities, why, we can find out then how many of them royalty bases they'll give us.
And I still can't understand what you're talking about, Lum.
Me neither.
Yeah, that's the trouble trying to explain things to such fellas as you. Have to put everything in such little bitty words. Me and Dick can sit up and talk by the hour using them big words and know what one another means nearly every time.
Well, now, if you're going to explain it to the stockholders, you better get it down in some words they'll understand or they'll be again it. I'll tell you that right now. I wouldn't vote for it.
Yeah, I expect I better make an announcement over the party line about the meeting before I forget it. Dick, do you mind if I use your telephone a minute?
No, go right ahead, Lum.
I'll give the far alarm ring. That always gets everybody to the phone.
Royalty base. Now, what does he want with one of them?
Yeah, I don't know, but I'm agin it.
More than likely old second-handed one, or they wouldn't want to swap it off in the first place. Operating on their capital. Who does he think he is, Doc Miller?
Be quiet. Howdy, everybody.
Get more.
There ain't no fire. I just want to make an announcement. This is Lum Edwards, president and general manager of the Great Western Sterling Silver Company. I just want to announce that there'll be an importance meeting of the stockholders at my place tonight. Be sure and be there. It's important. Huh? Well, I'll explain it when you get over to the meeting tonight. All right. Goodbye.
Wait a minute, Grandpap. We can't go to no meeting tonight.
Huh?
Don't you know, Goldie Ratcliffe asked us over to her house to the pie supper tonight.
Yeah, that's right. I'd forgot about it.
Why, sure.
Well, you can just call the pie supper off. This meeting's important. That's the reason you fellas don't ever get to be presidents and general managers of things. Always letting pleasure interfere with his business.
Well, come in, Frederick.
A man worthwhile is a man that can smile. All work and no play makes Jack a man that's got to put business ahead of everything else to make a success of himself today.
Mr. Lum, excuse me for butting in, but Miss Evelina told me to tell you something.
Miss Evelina Shules?
I forgot to tell you, Lum. Evelina's back. You know, school starts Monday, and she just a while ago got in.
Well, I do know. I never even know she was in town.
No.
She said for me to tell you that you and her was invited to the pie supper over at Goldie Rattler's tonight.
Hi, Grannies, wait a minute. Let me get to that telephone.
Oh, well, I was just excited to pieces. Can't wait to talk to her.
Too bad he's got to go to that meeting tonight.
Yeah, I reckon, Grandpap, me and you ought to go, too. Like he says, business ought to come first.
Howdy, everybody. This is Lum Edwards, president, and all of them other things of the silver mine. I just want to announce that the stockholders' meeting for tonight is called off on account of the pie supper over at Goldie Ratliff's tonight. We'll put the meeting off till tomorrow night, so everybody...
And tomorrow night's meeting will probably be held sometime next week with Evelina Schultz in town. Ladies and gentlemen, I've often told you what a fine aid Horlicks is to sound, refreshing sleep. Now listen to what Mr. C.A.R. of Connellsville, Pennsylvania, has to say.
Thanks for the wonderful malted milk you put on the market. For several years, I was in the habit of drinking coffee last thing at night and was unable to get my proper sleep. I was restless and dreaming all night. So after hearing Lum and Abner and about Horlicks, I thought I would try some myself. Now every night on retiring, I take a cup of Horlicks, hot. And believe me, when I get up in the morning, I feel like a new man. When my day's work is over, I feel as if I've just started. I can't recommend Horlicks too highly to anyone who sleeps poorly at night.
As this gentleman says, Horlicks is a fine aid to sound, refreshing sleep. Drink it hot, last thing at night, in place of tea or plain milk or coffee. It's so much easier to digest, more nourishing and sustaining. You can get Horlicks, you know, from your dealer in either natural or chocolate flavor. This is Carlton Bricker, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlicks, who now bid you all goodbye until Monday at the same time.